Hey, Dr. Huntington here, and in this video, I want to show you what researchers are saying about the link between vitamin D deficiency and cancer. I was reading through a couple of papers this morning, and I wanted to share this with you. So this is from a paper that was published in January of last year. Researchers noticed that cancer patients are vitamin D deficient much more often than the general population, and I think that's significant. In fact, it's just another reason why you don't want to have low vitamin D levels. Okay, so for some perspective on this, let's actually go back to a paper that was published 8 years ago. Now, this paper was published in the Journal of Nutrition Research, and it was published in January of 2011. It was called Prevalence and Correlates of Vitamin D Deficiency in U.S. Adults. It says here, mounting evidence suggests that vitamin D deficiency could be linked to several chronic diseases, including cardiovascular disease and cancer. If you're keeping track, that's number one and number two in terms of deaths in the United States. The purpose of this study was to examine the prevalence of vitamin D deficiency and its correlates to test the hypothesis that vitamin D deficiency was common in the U.S. population, especially in certain minority groups. Now, they go on to say here, vitamin D deficiency was defined as less than or equal to 20 nanograms per milliliter. So that's the nanogram per milliliter is just a unit of measure. So on the test, if it's using that unit of measure, it would be less than or equal to 20, would be what they're calling a deficiency. They say here, the overall prevalence rate of vitamin D deficiency was 41.6%, with the highest rate seen in blacks at 82.1, followed by Hispanics at 69.2. So what they're saying here is if I drew a scale here for you to be able to take a look at this, if we assume the bottom would be zero, right, like no vitamin D, and the top here 100, now you could go have more than 100, but I just put 100 as the top on the scale, about one-fifth the way up here I put 20. Right? So that's what they're calling deficiency, between 0 and 20. And what this paper's saying is that of all U.S. adults, 41.6 of everybody is in that area, 20 or less, which is what they're calling deficient. It says here, in summary, vitamin D deficiency was common, as we can see here in the U.S. population, especially among blacks and Hispanics, given that vitamin D deficiency is linked to some of the important risk factors of leading causes of death in the U.S., it is important that health professionals are aware of this connection and offer dietary and other intervention strategies to correct vitamin D deficiency. Now, despite this being published in 2011, how many doctors out there are actually monitoring their patients for vitamin D deficiency? Right, I mean, almost none. So, you know, unless you're seeing a doctor whose focus is on nutrition, you know, the popular term these days for this type of practice is functional medicine. So unless you're seeing a functional medicine doctor, it's not likely that you would even know that you're vitamin D deficient. Okay, so here's the paper from last year, right? This is the more recent paper. This one was published in a journal called The Current Problems in Cancer. The title is Vitamin D Deficiency in Cancer Patients and Predictors for Screening. Now, it says here, vitamin D is a prohormone. Now, prohormone, it just means that what vitamin D is a substance that is a precursor, that you could substitute the word precursor, right? So it's for prohormone, so it's a precursor to hormones. So vitamin D is a prohormone that is vital for calcium phosphate balance, bone structure, and physiological functioning. I listed those up here. I'll read it again. Vitamin D is a prohormone that is vital for calcium phosphate balance, right? That is extremely important. There, you know, if your calcium levels are not within a very normal but narrow range, you can have all kinds of bad diseases. I mean, this is crucial, right? Bone structure, I mean, we're not going anywhere without bones, right? You need healthy bones in order to be ambulatory and move and breathe and all those other things. Physiological function, I mean, you don't get more of a general overall statement. I mean, physiological function is basically everything, right? So you need vitamin D for all these things. Extremely important. They go on here to say the purpose of this study is to define the prevalence of vitamin D deficiency in cancer patients and establish the predictors of vitamin D deficiency to address a specific group of patient for screening. Okay, fine. So here's the results. In two cancer centers, 706 patients with a diagnosis of cancer were evaluated. So it's not a small study, right? 706 people. Vitamin D deficiency was present in 509 of them. That is 72%. So if we come back over here and we look, we've got the other paper saying 41.6% of people, of everybody, is deficient, right? But we're saying of cancer patients, the number is 72%. Now their conclusion, our study concluded the prevalence of vitamin D deficiency is high in cancer patients and female gender and people who have low sun exposure. Also in people who are like on post-cancer treatments, as well as people who have a history of gastrointestinal surgery. And so these parameters should be used for selecting patients for screening. Okay, so this paper was looking at identifying who should be screened for vitamin D deficiency, and that's a good thing for us to know. But I'm looking at this data and wondering how strong of a relationship there is between being vitamin D deficient and getting cancer, right? I mean, 41.6 of everybody is vitamin D deficient, but 72% of cancer patients are vitamin D deficient, right? So, what should really blow your mind is that while these papers are categorizing, you know, people at 20 or below, right? So less than or equal to 20, and there's the unit of measure, right? Or below as deficient, really vitamin D levels need to be north of like 60. I mean, for real function and ideally between 80 and 85, you know? So when you look at this chart, you know, 80 is going to be up in here somewhere. I mean, if 41% of everybody's down here, what percentage of the population, you know, if 80 is optimal, let's say 60 is going to be the lower end of what we want to say is going to help you function normally. How many people are 60 and below? I mean, the number has got to be enormous. And I don't know. I mean, maybe it's 80% of people or more truly need more vitamin D. Okay. So we take that data about cancer patients, you know, and a million other reasons, you know, to not be deficient in vitamin D. And we don't need to play with fire here. You know, if you are not already taking a vitamin D supplement daily, your levels are most likely too low. You know, and supplementing with a quality vitamin D product is easy, and it's inexpensive. You know, and remember, always take D3 with vitamin K2. Those have to be taken together. And that's how I formulated my vitamin D supplement, which is available at BodyManual.com. It's called vitamin D3K2, and it comes in an easy-to-swallow capsule. All right, so that's the news today on vitamin D. I'll see you in the next video.